क्वेश्चन नंबर 52। फ्रॉम द फॉलोइंग बैलेंस शीट ऑफ SRS लिमिटेड एंड द एडिशनल इंफॉर्मेशन एज ऑन 31st March 2016, प्रिपेयर अ कैश फ्लो स्टेटमेंट। करेंट ईयर वैल्यूज एंड प्रीवियस ईयर वैल्यूज आर गिवन डियर चिल्ड्रन। शेयर कैपिटल विल गो इन फाइनेंसिंग एक्टिविटी, रिजर्व एंड सरप्लस, ऑपरेटिंग, लॉन्ग टर्म बोरोइंग, फाइनेंसिंग एक्टिविटी, शॉर्ट टर्म बोरोइंग, ऑल्दो इट इज करेंट लाइबिलिटी बट इट विल बी रिकॉर्डेड अंडर फाइनेंसिंग एक्टिविटी एंड एक्सेप्शन। शॉर्ट टर्म प्रोविजन, ऑपरेटिंग एक्टिविटी इफ प्रोविजन फॉर टैक्स इज गिवन। देन अंडर नॉन करेंट एसेट्स टेंजिबल एसेट्स आर गिवन, ऑपरेटिंग एक्टिविटी, सॉरी नॉट ऑपरेटिंग, टेंजिबल एसेट्स आर रिकॉर्डेड अंडर इन्वेस्टिंग एक्टिविटी। Intangible point number 6 is given. Let's see what is given point number 6 in goodwill. So it means it will be recorded under operating activity, non-current investment, investment activity, current assets and cash equivalent both are recorded in C&CE, cash and cash equivalent both are recorded together. Inventories under operating activity, all these points are over. Reserve and surplus, so profit and loss is given, surplus will be recorded under operating. Debentures, financing activity, bank overdraft, financing activity, provision for tax, operating, machinery, investing, and accumulated debt is given. It means we will calculate current year debt and that will be recorded under operating activity. Intangible assets, under intangible assets what is given? Goodwill, so goodwill written off. Operating activity, stock, operating activity. Two adjustments are given here. 50,000, 12% debentures were issued on 31st March 16. So what does it mean? 31st March 16, it means it is increased from 175 to 225. So debentures of rupees 50,000 are issued on 31st March 16. It means we need to calculate interest on 1,75,000, 12% interest on 1,75,000. This is what it means. There is one more adjustment. During the year, a piece of machinery costing 40, on which accumulated debt was 20, sold at a loss of 5. Okay, so we have to prepare machinery account. We have to prepare accumulated debt account. Two accounts we are going to prepare. A very good question, dear children. This question was the part of All India 2017 CBSE question paper. Let me start. Okay, dear children. First, I will prepare accumulated depreciation account. Question number 52. Working note number 1. First, I will prepare accumulated depreciation account. Depreciation account starts from credit side. What do we write? Opening balance by balance brought down. So opening balance will be recorded here. How much opening balance is given? Let's see. Accumulated debt opening balance is given 70,000. So by balance BD 70,000. Closing balance will come in debit side. To balance carried down. How much closing balance is given? Closing balance is given 1,05,000. 1,05,000. Okay. And what happened? During a year, a machinery costing 40 on which accumulated debt was 20. So this accumulated debt of sold machine will come in debit side by the name to machine account. And the balance will remaining in the credit side. 1,05,000 plus 20 is equal to 1,25,000. 1,25,000 minus 70,000 is equal to 55,000. Yes or no? So what does this 55,000 know? This is your current year depreciation account, children, right? By depreciation account, this is your current year debt. And where do we record current year debt? In non-cash expenses, in operating activities. आई होप एक्युमुलेटेड डेप्रिसिएशन अकाउंट इज क्लियर टू एवरीवन। वी नीड टू प्रिपेयर वन मोर अकाउंट है ना, दैट इज मशीनरी अकाउंट। मशीन अकाउंट वी विल प्रिपेयर, सो आई विल प्रिपेयर। मशीन अकाउंट ओके, मशीन अकाउंट स्टार्ट फ्रॉम डेबिट साइड, इट्स अ रियल अकाउंट है ना। व्हाट डू वी राइट? फर्स्ट वी राइट ओपनिंग बैलेंस ऑफ मशीन 5,22,500, टू बैलेंस ब्रॉट डाउन, टू बैलेंस ब्रॉट डाउन 5,22,500, क्लोजिंग बैलेंस विल कम इन क्रेडिट साइड by balance carried down 8,37,500, 8,37,500. Then what we write? We write by accumulated depreciation account. The value will come from accumulated depreciation account, this 20,000. We have written machine account here. So this accumulated depreciation will come in the credit side. Then machine is sold, this will be given in adjustment. So let us see how much it is sold for. Costing 40, on which accumulated debt was 20, sold at a loss of 5. It means the cost of machine was 40,000 and accumulated debt was 20,000. It means the written down value of machine is 20,000. And it was sold at a loss of 5. If it was sold at a loss of 5, at what price it has been sold? It means it is sold for rupees 15,000. Yes or no? Written down value is 20,000. Book value is 20,000 and sold for 5,000 loss. It means it is sold for 15,000. So by bank account 15,000, and loss will also come in the credit side by statement of profit and loss. Loss. Is that clear? Now let's check where balance is remaining. So balance is remaining in debit side because credit side is more. So 20 plus 15, 35 plus 5, 40. 8,37,500 plus 40,000 is equal to 8,77,500. Let me take out the balance, है ना? 8,77,500 minus 5,22,500 is equal to 3,55,000. Children, if balance remain in debit side, what does it mean?
Purchase.
Purchase. It is to bank. We write to bank, but it is purchase of machine. And purchase of machine is recorded where? It is recorded in investing activity. Okay, so these two working notes are prepared. I hope it is clear. Now let us start cash flow statement. Cash flow statement. Okay. First activity is cash flow from operating activity. Cash flow from operating activities. So let's begin. From where do we start? We start from surplus. This is net profit after tax. Let us see it is given or not. It is given in the notes to account, surplus. Earlier it was 50, now it is 1,25,000. It means 75,000 profit, hai na, current year minus previous year. So 75,000 surplus. Then we add some appropriations. Let's see appropriations are given or not, like transfer to reserve or provision for tax of current year. Yes, provision for tax of current year is given, 1 lakh rupees, hai na. वी एड प्रोविजन फॉर टैक्स ऑफ करेंट ईयर. हाउ मच? 1 lakh इज गिवन, सो वी एड 1 lakh. देन वी चेक ट्रांसफर टू रिजर्व, फॉर ट्रांसफर टू रिजर्व इज नॉट गिवन हियर. देन वी सी अबाउट डिविडेंड्स, सो इन एडजस्टमेंट ऑल्सो नथिंग इज मेंशन अबाउट डिविडेंड. इट मीन्स ओनली दीज टू पॉइंट्स आर विथ अस, 1,75,000. दिस इज अवर प्रॉफिट, दैट प्रॉफिट बिफोर टैक्स. देन वॉट वी नीड टू डू, वी नीड टू एड नॉन कैश एक्सपेंसेस. नॉन कैश एक्सपेंसेस, देर आर टू नॉन कैश एक्सपेंसेस, वन इज डेप्रिसिएशन एंड वन इज एमर्टाइजेशन. सो वी हैव सीन करेंट ईयर डेप्रिसिएशन, डेप्रिसिएशन ऑफ करेंट ईयर, एंड वी हैव कंप्यूटेड इन एक्यूमुलेटेड डेप अकाउंट. हाउ मच? 55,000, है ना? सो 55,000 विल बी रिकॉर्डेड. ओके, देन वी सी एमर्टाइजेशन, गुडविल रिटर्न ऑफ. सो हियर गुडविल रिटर्न ऑफ इज ऑल्सो गिवन, 75 to 50 means 25,000 goodwill return off, that is 25,000. Now what we add? We add non-operating expenses, non-operating expenses. So let's see non-operating expenses are given or not. Come in adjustment. So 12% debentures were issued. So 12% is rate of interest on debentures, hai na? So interest on debentures we need to write here. First, interest on debentures, that will be 12%. So 12% of what? 12% of 1,75,000, hai na? So 12% of 1,75,000. Let me calculate. 1,75,000 into 12%, that is 21,000 interest on debenture. Then loss on sale of machine is also given. Loss on sale of machine is non-operating expenses. It is given in adjustment. Sold at a loss of 5,000, you know? So 5,000. Then we need to write the non-operating income. Non-operating incomes are normally given in adjustment. It is not given here. Let us check notes to account also. It is not given here also. So there is no non-operating income. So let us add all these values. So let me add 1,75,000 plus 55,000 plus 25,000 plus 21 plus 5, 26,000 is equal to 2,81,000. 2,81,000. This is our operating profit before working capital changes. Now what we need to do? We need to adjust some current assets and current liabilities. So we write adjustment for working capital changes. Okay. So let's begin. Let's see some current assets and current liabilities. So we begin with current liabilities. Short-term borrowings, financing, short-term provision is done. This is provision for tax. Now let's come in current assets. In current assets, only inventories are given. 36 to 61, note number 7 is given. So let's go in note number 7, the stock in trade. So increase in stock in trade. Increase in stock in trade. How much? Earlier 61, now earlier 36. 61 minus 36, 25,000. So increase in stock in trade by 25,000 result in outflow of cash. Cash goes out when stock increases. Okay. So all points are over. Let me subtract 2,81,000 minus 25,000, 2,56,000. This is your cash generated from operations. This is what cash generated. Then we need to pay tax, less tax paid. And from where do we get tax? Provision for tax of previous year. 62,500 is tax paid. So let's 62,500 be subtracted. Let me subtract 256,000 minus 62,500. We will get 193,500 positive. So it will be considered as cash flow from operating activities. Okay, dear children, is it clear to everyone? Let us check it is correct or not. Let me check. 193,500. Yes, children, cash flow from operating activities is 193,500. Hai na? So let us move on investing activity. Okay. So second activity is cash flow from investing activity. Cash flow from investing activity. What do we write in investing activities? Majorly, non-current assets and non-current investment are recorded under investing activity. So children, we have prepared machine account, yes or no? In machine account, we have purchased one machine for rupees 3,55,000. है ना? So machine purchased, पर purchase of machine, how much? 3,55,000 result in outflow of cash. We have sold some part of machine, yes, for rupees 15,000. Here it is mentioned in the account, है ना? Sale of machine for rupees 15,000. Sale of machine 15,000. Then let's see what else is given in non-current assets. Non-current assets, tangible asset is over and intangible will not come. This is goodwill, and non-current investment is also given 50 to 75. So it means this is purchase of non-current investment, hai na? So purchase of non-current investment by 25,000. So it will result in outflow of cash. Let me do the total. 3,55,000 plus 25,000 minus 15,000 is equal to 3,65,000 negative. So I will put bracket for negative sign. So this is cash used in investing activity. Cash used in investing activity. I hope it is clear, dear children. Cash used in investing activity. Now the next activity is financing activity, third activity. Cash flow from financing activities. What do we write in financing activities? We write shareholder fund plus non-current liability, isn't it? So let's check shareholder fund and non-current liabilities. Share capital is given. Earlier it was 350, now it is 450, increased by 1 lakh rupees. So issue of share capital. Issue of share capital by 1 lakh. Then non-current liabilities, long-term borrowing is given, note number 2. So let's come on note number 2. It is debenture, 12% debenture, increased by 50,000. So issue of 12% debentures. Issue of 12% debentures, 50,000. Inflow of cash by issue of share capital and debenture. Then interest on debenture is also paid. Interest on debentures. How much we have computed? Interest on debentures, 1,75,000 into 12%. 21,000, so interest on debenture is paid 21,000. Increase in bank overdraft by rupees 37,500 result in inflow of cash. Now let me do the total. 1,50,000 plus 37,500 minus 21,000 is equal to 1,66,500 positive value, so it is known as cash flow from financing activities. Now what we do? Now we do the total of all these three activities, right? So let me do the total. 1,66,500 minus 3,65,000 and plus 1,93,500 is equal to minus 5,000. It means the total of these three activities is negative. So what we call it? We call it net decrease in cash and cash equivalent. Yes or no? Now what we add in it? We will add opening cash and cash equivalent. Let's check how much opening cash and cash equivalent is given. So it is given 35,000 and 26,500. So 35,000 plus 26,500. I will write here 35,000 plus 26,500. Current investment is also considered as cash and cash equivalent, is equal to 61,500. And let me solve. 61,500 minus 5,000 is equal to 56,500. So the total of closing cash and cash equivalent must be equal to closing cash and cash equivalent must be equal to 56,500. Let's check. It is given 20,000 and 36,500. 20,000 plus 36,500 is equal to 56,500. I hope the question is clear to everyone. Yes, dear children. Question number 53. Let's start with question number 53. Following is the summarized balance sheet of Philips Limited, Philips India Limited. So current year and previous year is given. Share capital will be recorded in financing activity, reserve and surplus operating, mortgage loan financing activity, trade payable creditors operating, provision for tax operating, isn't it? Tangible assets investing, non-current investment investing, current assets cash and cash equivalent, inventory is operating, trade receivable operating, and bank cash and cash equivalent. Then notes to account, reserve, general reserve is given, operating, profit and loss operating, additional information is given, investment costing 24,000 were sold for the year 25,500. It means we need to prepare investment account. Provision for tax made during the year 27,000. It means we need to prepare provision for tax account. Okay. During the year, a part of fixed assets costing 30 was sold for 36,000. The profits were included in the statement of profit and loss. It means we need to prepare fixed assets account. Hana? The interim dividend paid during the year 1,20,000. We will remember this part. So let's begin. So first I will prepare a investment account, right? Investments are given, non-current investment. Okay. Question number 53. Working note number 1. First I will prepare non-current investment account. डेबिट साइड क्रेडिट साइड स्टार्ट फ्रॉम डेबिट साइड, ओपनिंग बैलेंस पे रिकॉर्ड फर्स्ट इन डेबिट साइड, बैलेंस ब्रॉट डाउन एंड ओपनिंग बैलेंस ऑफ नॉन करेंट इन्वेस्टमेंट इज गिवन 1,50,000, 1,50,000, क्लोजिंग बैलेंस विल कम इन क्रेडिट साइड बाय बैलेंस कैरिड डाउन 1,80,000 क्लोजिंग बैलेंस. इन एडजस्टमेंट इट इज मेंशन्ड इन्वेस्टमेंट कॉस्टिंग 24 वर सोल्ड फॉर द ईयर 25, सोल्ड ड्यूरिंग द ईयर फॉर 25,500 बाय बैंक अकाउंट 25,500 इट हैज बीन सोल्ड बट कॉस्ट वॉज 20,000 सोल्ड फॉर 25,500 इट मीन्स 25,500 माइनस 24,000 1,500 इज द प्रॉफिट ऑन सेल ऑफ इन्वेस्टमेंट है ना. दिस इज योर गेन ऑन सेल ऑफ इन्वेस्टमेंट 1,500. Where do we record 1500? In debit side to statement of profit and loss. Now where balance is remaining? Balance is remaining in debit side. Let me check how much. 1,80,000 plus 25, so it will be 2,05,500. है ना? So 2,05,500. 2,05,500 माइनस 1,51,500 सो द बैलेंस इज 54,000 विच इज रिमेनिंग इन द डेबिट साइड. व्हाट डज इट मीन इफ बैलेंस रिमेन इन डेबिट साइड? वी राइट इट टू बैंक अकाउंट एंड चिल्ड्रन दिस इज परचेज. यस दिस इज परचेज ऑफ नॉन करेंट इन्वेस्टमेंट and this purchase of non-current investment will be recorded in investing activity and this sale of investment will also be recorded. So this is our first working note. Second working note we will prepare for provision for tax account. Let me prepare provision for tax account. Provision for tax account starts from credit side. What do we write? By balance brought down, the opening balance of provision for tax. So let's see how much it is given. Provision for tax is given 2,25,000 opening balance. 2,25,000 closing balance will come in debit side to balance carried down. It is given 30,000. 30,000 closing balance will come here. Now let's see how much tax paid is given in adjustment. Provision for tax made during the year 27,000. Okay, so current year provision is given, you know. It means by statement of profit and loss. This is current year provision. 27,000 is given. Let me check where balance is remaining. It is remaining in debit side. 2,25,000 plus 27,000 is equal to 2,52,000. And 2,52,000 minus 30,000 is equal to 2,22,000. If balance remains in debit side in provision for tax, what does it mean? To bank account. And children, it is tax paid. And you know where do we write tax paid? Tax paid is subtracted in operating activity, you know, at the end. Now, according to adjustment, during the year, a part of fixed assets costing 30 sold for 36. It means we need to prepare fixed asset account also, है ना? And fixed assets are given. Fine, it is given. So let me prepare fixed asset account. Working note number 3. Fixed assets account. Debit side, credit side. From where it will start? It starts from debit side. What do we write? To balance brought down. Opening balance. Let's see how much opening balance of fixed asset is given. 12 lakh. Closing balance will come in credit side. By balance carried down, how much closing balance is given? Closing balance is given 9,60,000. 9,60,000. No other information is given here. Only in the adjustment number 3 it is given. During the year, a part of fixed assets costing 30 was sold for 36. Sold for 36 means by bank. Sold for 36, but the cost was 30. It means 6,000 profit. It has been sold for the gain of rupees 6,000. 6,000 gain will come in debit side to statement of profit and loss. This is gain on sale of fixed asset. Now, where balance is remaining? Balance is remaining in debit side. 12,06,000. 12,06,000 minus 9,96,000. So it is coming 2,10,000. So what is this 2,10,000? Tell me, dear children, this balance. This is your current year depreciation account. By depreciation account. This is your current year depreciation. Where do we write current year depreciation? We write current year depreciation in operating activities in non-cash expenses, है ना? Okay. So let's begin cash flow from operating activities. Cash flow statement. कैश फ्लो स्टेटमेंट फर्स्ट एक्टिविटी इज कैश फ्लो फ्रॉम ऑपरेटिंग एक्टिविटी कैश फ्लो फ्रॉम ऑपरेटिंग एक्टिविटीज फ्रॉम वेयर डू वी स्टार्ट वी स्टार्ट विथ सरप्लस लेट्स चेक हाउ मच इट इज गिवन Surplus is given earlier it was 168, now it is 2,04,000, है ना? So let's check the difference. 2,04,000 minus 1,68, it means 36,000. So surplus is given 36,000. Now we need to add some appropriations like provision for tax of current year. How much it is? It is given provision for tax made during the year 27,000. 27,000. Then let us see if there is any transfer to reserve. Yes, transfer to reserve is given 9 lakh to 9 lakh 30. 30,000 transfer to general reserve. Transfer to general reserve 30,000. Then we check if there is any dividend which is given. So interim dividend paid during the year 1,20,000. Interim dividend paid 1,20,000, है ना? 1,20,000 and any other appropriations? No other appropriations are given now. So let me add these points. 36,000 plus 27,000 plus 30,000 plus 1,20,000. It comes 2,13,000. This is net profit before tax. Extraordinary items are not given. That's why I am not writing an extraordinary items. Then what do we add here? We add non-cash expenses. Yes, children. Non-cash expenses. What do we write first under it? We write depreciation of current year. Depreciation of current year. Children, we have computed depreciation of current year. Hai na? How much we have computed in machine account, fixed asset account? That is 2,10,000 depreciation of current year. So 2,10,000. Let's check if there is any intangible assets given. So intangible assets are not given. Okay. So then what we add? Non-operating expenses. So under non-operating expenses, what is given? Let's check first in adjustment. In adjustment, you can see okay, it is nothing is given here, hai na? Nothing is sold at a loss, and interest on mortgage loan, definitely it will come. And when the loan has been taken, we have seen is not mentioned, maybe the date is not mentioned. So we can assume here, hai na? We can assume because date is not mentioned in the adjustment na? So we will assume that loan is taken at the end of the year, hai na? This is what we can do. So there is no non-operating expenses. Then what we subtract? Non-operating income. Under non-operating incomes, there are non-operating incomes, hai na? Because investment are sold for the gain of 1500. So gain on sale of investment. Gain on sale of investment, that is 1500. Then there is one more thing, gain on sale of fixed assets, 6000, hai na? Gain on sale of fixed asset, 6000, that will also be subtracted. Let's see any other gain is given. No, nothing is mentioned here. So what to do? Just do the total. Let me do the total. 2,13,000 plus 2,10,000 minus 7,500 is equal to 4,15,500. Children, this is your operating profit before working capital changes. Add some differences of current assets and current liabilities. So adjustment for working capital changes we need to do. So let's begin with current liabilities. So you can see current liabilities here only trade creditors are given, trade payables creditors are given. Earlier it was 5,04,000, now it is 4,02,000. It means there is a difference of 1,02,000. So decrease in trade payable. Decrease in trade payables by 1,02,000 result in outflow of cash, isn't it? And provision for tax we have already taken into consideration. Fine. देन कम ऑन करंट एसेट्स. करंट इन्वेस्टमेंट इज द पार्ट ऑफ कैश एंड कैश इक्विवेलेंट. ओके, इन्वेंट्री इज गिवन, सो देर इज अ डिक्रीज इन इन्वेंट्री, है ना, 720 माइनस 630, सो इट इज 90,000. सो डिक्रीज इन इन्वेंट्रीज बाय 90,000. डिक्रीज इन इन्वेंट्रीज बाय 90,000 रिजल्ट इन आउट इनफ्लो ऑफ कैश, इजंट इट? इन्वेंट्री इज ओवर, ट्रेड रिसीवेबल इज लेफ्ट, सो इंक्रीज इन ट्रेड रिसीवेबल, लेट्स सी हाउ मच. सो 13,65,000 माइनस 6,30,000 इज इक्वल टू 7,35,000, है ना. सो इंक्रीज इन ट्रेड रिसीवेबल बाय 7,35,000. इंक्रीज इन ट्रेड रिसीवेबल बाय 7,35,000 रिजल्ट इन आउटफ्लो ऑफ कैश. ओके, सो करंट एसेट्स एंड करंट लाइबिलिटीज आर ओवर. सो लेट मी डू द टोटल. 4,15,500 माइनस 1,02,000 प्लस 90,000 एंड माइनस 7,35,000 इज इक्वल टू 3,31,500, बट इट कम्स नेगेटिव. ओके, एंड देन व्हाट वी नीड टू डू, वी नीड टू सब्ट्रैक्ट टैक्स पेड. एंड चिल्ड्रन, टैक्स पेड वी हैव कंप्यूटेड वेयर इन प्रोविजन फॉर टैक्स अकाउंट. सो लेट्स सी हाउ मच. टैक्स पेड इज 2,22,000 वी हैव टेकन. सो 2,22,000 टैक्स पेड, 2,22,000 is to be subtracted, and then see, let's see what we get. 2,22,000, so 5,53,500 negative. It means this is cash used in operating activity. Cash used in operating activity. Okay, from investing activity. What do we write in investing activity? We write non-current assets and non-current investment. So let's see non-current investment and non-current investment. So in non-current assets, there are two, tangible and non-current investment, both are given. And for this, we have prepared machine account, hai na? We have prepared. So let's check. Fixed account is prepared. Yes, fixed account is prepared by bank. It means this is sale of fixed asset. Hai na? So we'll write sale of fixed assets 36,000. Sale of fixed asset, that is 36,000, result in inflow of cash. Okay. Then let's see what else we have prepared. We have prepared a non-current investment account also. So here 54,000 is written in the debit side, that is purchase of non-current investment. 54,000, hai na? Purchase of non-current investment. Purchase of non-current investment, that is 54,000, result in outflow of cash. And there is one more point under non-current investment, 25,500. Sale of non-current investment by 25,500. Sale of non-current investment, 25,500. So sale of non-current investment result in inflow of cash, hai na? And I hope all points are over here, because only these two points are given here, non-current investment and property, plant and equipment, hai na? And in adjustment also, nothing is given in adjustment. Yes, nothing is given in adjustment. Okay, so let's do the total. 36,000 minus 54,000 plus 25,500 इज इक्वल टू 7,500 पॉजिटिव, इट मीन्स दिस इज कैश फ्लो फ्रॉम इन्वेस्टिंग एक्टिविटी, कैश फ्लो फ्रॉम इन्वेस्टिंग एक्टिविटी, isn't it? Then third activity which we need to prepare is cash flow from financing activity. Cash flow from financing activities. In financing activity, what do we write? In financing activity, we write shareholder fund plus non-current liabilities. Yes or no? So let's check shareholder fund. है ना? So equity share capital, there is no change. Reserve and surplus is written. Long-term borrowing. In opening, it was not given. It means we have raised 10% mortgage loan by 8,10,000. Increase in long-term borrowing by 8,10,000 cash inflow, and we have assumed in this question that long-term borrowing is raised at the end of the year on 31st March, so that's why no interest is applicable here, hai na? And let's see what else is given in adjustment. Interim dividend paid during the year 1,20,000, है ना? So that is also to be recorded in financing activity. 1,20,000 interim dividend paid. Interim dividend paid 1,20,000 result in outflow of cash. So all points are over, isn't it? So let's do the total. 8,10,000 minus 1,20,000 is equal to 6,90,000 positive. It means this is your cash flow from financing activity. Cash flow from financing activity. है ना? Now what we do? We add all these three activities. So 6,90,000 plus 7,500 and minus 5,53,500 is equal to 1,44,000 positive value. What we call it? It is known as net increase in cash and cash equivalent. Okay, then what we add? We add opening cash and cash equivalent. Opening cash and cash equivalent. Let's check how much opening cash and cash equivalent is given. So you can see current investment is also given. So 17 plus 4,30,000. This is opening cash and cash equivalent. 4,30,000 plus 17, 4,47,000. है ना? 4,30,000 plus 17,000 is equal to 4,47,000. And when we add 1,44,000 plus 4,47,000, what we get? 5,91,000. And this must be equal to closing cash and cash equivalent. Closing cash and cash equivalent. So let's check how much closing cash is given. It is given 21,570,000. So 5,70,000 plus 21,000 is equal to 5,91,000. Hai na? I hope it is clear to everyone. Yes, dear children.